a CCZ press statement dated 22 December 2017. Following the letter that we wrote on the 17th of December 2017 in a reference notice of recalling Archbishop Johannes Nyangwa Ndanga from the office of the President of the Apostolic Christian Council of Zimbabwe, ACCZ, following a series of constitutional violation of the operational tenets and mandates of the Apostolic Christian Council of Zimbabwe, ACCZ, by Archbishop Johannes Nyangwa Ndanga, who is the life president of the council, as claimed. The constitutional violation have triggered and raised grievous concerns among many bishops whose churches are affiliated to ACCZ and have anonymously recommended the recalling of Dr. Johannes Nyangwa Ndanga as the president of the Apostolic Christian Council of Zimbabwe with immediate effect due to the following reasons, among others. Archbishop Johannes Ndanga has violated the constitution of ACCZ section 2 by manipulating the appointment of ACCZ patrons without agreeing with the Apostolic Bishops' Conference. Number two, unlawfully and illiterally appointment of people to positions without following the laid down procedures in the Constitution, especially the appointments of the current executive board, which its legality is rendered a nullity as bishops representing province have dissolved the board with immediate effect. Archbishop Ndanga, you were solely in control of all the ACCZ properties in violation of section 7.1 of the Constitution, which reads, the Apostolic Bishops' Conference shall be responsible for execution of the general policies of ACCZ and to provide for management, administration, and control of all affairs and property of ACCZ, which therefore you are directed to bring back the properties within a period of 14 days. Archbishop Ndanga, you failed to run the council that caused the council to lose its offices in contravention of section 13.3, says the books of accounts shall be kept at registered office of ACCZ or at such other places as the ABC may think fit and shall always be open to the inspection of ACCZ. Apparently, the ABC is unaware of where the aforementioned books of accounts and other records are kept. Archbishop Ndanga, as the president and chairman of the ABC, failed to uphold a professional upkeep of the books of accounts according to section 13.4 of the Constitution and caused those books to be subjected to an audit in accordance with the provision of section 13.5. According to our Constitution, section 17.1, the amendment of the Constitution is supposed to be done at an annual or a special general meeting of ACCZ by two-thirds vote of paid up ordinary members and regional delegates present and voting. But you violated the ACZ constitution and amended it without record, alone or with a few individuals, not at annual general meeting, accommodating yourself as the executive and life president of ACCZ. There are more people willing to come forward with further litan of charges against you, Archbishop Ndanga, and your administration, and you as the head, you are accountable for everything, as such leaving the reins of ACCZ is most honorable thing to do now. And the new administration will preserve you are the legacy that you and all the founding fathers built through the years. Thank you so much. May God bless you. As ABC, we are going to hold an extraordinary congress so that we may choose the one who is going to replace his position. But as for the meantime, we appointed an interim committee which is leading this process.
What is ABC?
ABC is the Apostolic Bishops Conference, which is a governing board, the high board of the Apostolic Christian Council of Zimbabwe, a decision-making board.
Which comprises of all bishops.
Okay, and the next person who's going to come in is going to be taking charge under the capacity of like president or just president?
Just a president. Was according to our original constitution, the president should be a ceremonial president who is going to, what can I say, to be given what to the procedures by the ABCD, by the ABC, the Apostolic Bishops Conference.
In fact, as far as our constitution is concerned, the president is below the ABC, which means the control body itself is the ABC, which comprises of bishops. And up below ABC, there's a board of governors. I am now giving you what's tabulated in our constitution. There's also a board of governors. Board of governors now, that's where the president comes in. And the president has no mandate to control ACCZ on his own. This is why we have now recalled the Ndanga. Ndanga failed to comply with our constitution. If he has at all complied with our constitution, then we'll be on another stage. But now as we talk, we have tabulated or we have pointed out the areas that we are charging him with as ACCZ.
Okay,
quite right. He's just taken from other sources. In fact, he's talking from the grapevine, which we are not taking into account. We are still waiting for him to respond, because initially he should respond to the letter as we wrote a letter to him. We didn't just tell people to go and tell him what our concerns were. We wrote him a letter, and in the response, we expect him also to write a letter to us, telling us his position.
Did you give him any time frame to respond?
We gave him 14 days.
Okay. On a different note, pakati wasupasandi kwa mapostola akawanda, the former first lady Grace Mugabe wakapromisa 1 million tons of rice. Kwazo rice iyo yakazouya.
Rice hatina kuzouya, hatina kuita ma efforts ekuritora chikonzeroka. That was an arrangement. Yakanga iri pakati pa vandanga na patron wao, of which that patron is not our patron. Saka isisu tag atina power yekunoritora.
Check, 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 Tanga.